Hey everybody, today I want to talk about Isotropic's new render engine for Clarice called Angie. So Angie is a hybrid render that can use the CPUs and the GPUs, and they just released an early access. So we're going to get into that, but before I do, I want to kind of give you guys a background on what the software Clarice is, because I've talked about it in past videos, but I don't think I've really gone into depth and really explained the reasons why you would use Clarice. So why would you use Clarice? Well, Clarice is a scene assembly, look dev, and lighting renderer. So it's its own software that you can basically scatter trillions of polygons. So a big problem I've had in the past is I'm trying to create a big scene and I can't because my computer just can't handle. Like I've hit a point where I couldn't even navigate the display window just because I had too many polygons. And sometimes optimizing takes more time. So then you're spending less time making your scene look better. So you're having to spend more time fixing versus creating. So Clarice is nice because you can bring all of those assets from any of your different 3D software. So if you're a Blender user, great. If you're a Cinema 4D user, if you're a Houdini, if you're a Maya, 3ds Max, it doesn't matter. You can create your assets in there. You can send them over to Clarice and you can scatter them and create your world. A lot of times I'll even animate my camera and set the base of a landscape or a scene in one of those other 3D packages and then bring it over. And then that's where I really get to dial in my scene and create a lot of stuff. So Clarice can bring in super high polys, like I said before. And you can make trillions and trillions of polygons and you can still navigate through your scene just fine. They have a scattering tool that you just, like a paintbrush, are just scattering the highest poly assets, and it's amazing. And that was one of the first reasons why I started using it, is because I wanted to make these bigger scenes. So that's another really cool thing. So you can import OBJs and Alembics. You cannot import FBX files, so keep that in mind. Oh yeah, and USDs, you can import USDs. So in the past, Clarice had their own render engine and it was CPU only. But now we have a new GPU renderer in Clarice called Angie. So before we get into that, let's talk about a couple movies that you guys have seen and probably didn't know was using Clarice. So if this past year you saw the movie Dune, well, you were looking at a ton of Clarice renders. Those huge environments, those big spaceships, those mountains, those cities, the sand part, all of that. That is Clarice. Clarice can handle those massive scenes, and it did it beautifully. That was created by the company DNEG, the studio DNEG, and they've done Blade Runner, they've done Avengers, they've done just a bunch of different stuff. Venom, the new Venom 2 movie. So if you're seeing those renders and you're seeing those beautiful landscapes or characters all rendered up, that was Clarice. So I know ILM uses Clarice as well, and I believe Fuse Effects is starting to use Clarice for their environments as well. So a lot of studios use Clarice and they love it. Oh, kind of fun. I've talked to a lot of artists, look dev artists that use Clarice, and they all absolutely loved it. And they'll use whatever render engine their studio uses, but so many of these artists that I've talked to personally absolutely love their experience using Clarice. So you can go give it a shot and see how you enjoy it and push it to its limits. And now let's talk about Angie. Out of the gate, the 3D viewer, when I jumped in and started using Clarice, was just so much faster. Already Clarice was really fast, but when I was using my computer with the 3080 in it, it was like real time. It was such a nice experience, and I just felt like not having to wait, like being able to not wait and iterate on your work can make your work better. Sometimes if you're waiting all the time to see your results, it just gets kind of painful and it makes it so it's harder for you to make it look better and better and better. Whereas if you can iterate, the faster you can iterate, in my opinion, the better your work will start looking, because you can make changes quicker and you can see things happening quicker. So it was seriously like near real time using my 3080. It was so much fun. And so I was taking Quixel assets. The bridge doesn't work yet, so I would just go to the source files, bring in a asset, and just like, I could just duplicate super quick, duplicate, you know, and just stamp it wherever I want. It was amazing. So it was just really fun to feel like I could navigate super quick. The cool thing they've done with Angie is they've made it so simple too. The render before, like, I felt like I had to go into the settings and like, okay, how many samples do I need here? You know, there was still some optimization you had to do, and you had to really think about your materials and your lights and how bright they are. There's just a lot of things. With Angie, I just have to put the noise threshold. So if I'm willing to tolerate 2% noise, it'll give me 2% noise. Or 1%, which is the cleanest you can get, I'll put it to 1%. And I'm like, oh yes. And the way the renderer works now is it prioritizes areas of your image. So let's say you have a refractive object, it's going to prioritize putting more samples into that area than it would a super diffused, no specular kind of object. So you can actually see where it prioritizes the samples, and so it makes it way faster because it says, oh, I don't need to spend a lot of time in here, this doesn't mean as many samples, let's work on this part, which is so cool. So the simplicity of the renderer also just makes it that much more appealing. The other cool thing that I personally like was you can also set a time. So if I'm like, you know what, I have a deadline, I can only spend 60 seconds on each frame if I'm gonna be able to do 120 frames or something. So I can literally spend 60 seconds on this frame, and it will get it to as clean as a render as it can within that 60 seconds, which was so cool. One caveat, so it uses, I said, a GPU for now. Angie eventually will allow you to have multiple GPUs, but not yet. But in the future, like I said, when they do the actual release, it will be able to use all your GPUs. The early access also cannot do motion blur yet. It will, but they're working on it. So another, a couple other crazy cool things about Angie is the materials. I haven't even gotten into the materials. So currently, Clarice has its own material system, and it all goes through what's called OSL. Now they have built in your own OSL shading. So it's not having to convert your Clarice materials into OSL. You can just use OSL, so it goes even faster. So OSLs are awesome because there's communities of people that make OSL shaders, and you can bring those in, which is really cool. And the other big thing is Material X. So if you don't know what Material X is, it is the future of shading. So what is starting to happen and what is going to happen is it will be a universal material used across all 3D applications and probably all render engines. So we will all be using the same materials, which I think is the way to go. So if you're using, I know in Arnold, Arnold and Houdini, you can make a material with material, or you can export your, I believe, Arnold material out as Material X, and then you could bring it into Clarice. So you can, there's an import for Material X, which is so cool. And so we're gonna see in the future libraries of Material X's, people making their own materials, and then sharing them, selling them, whatever. It's gonna be the future. We're gonna see it in Substance, so you'll make something in Substance with Material X, throw it over. And that's really cool. I know right now Houdini has Material X, and there's been some discussion in the Clarice community, and people have tested it, and it worked. So already you're seeing people try to figure out, oh, I can, you know, start to shade something in Karma in Houdini and using Material X, and I can export it, save it, and bring it into Clarice. You have to be using the latest version of Houdini, so just keep that in mind as well. It's gonna be nice for big studios too, because a lot of times they're having to share, they're having to work on one film and they need the look to stay the same. And you're gonna have people using, oh, here's my Material X for the hair or something, you know, or the volumes, and they're like, oh, there we go. And they can just pass them back and forth. So another really cool thing is they have a previs window in the 3D window. And this allows you to just look dev your stuff really quickly without actually using the PBR, without having to render. You can just open it up and you can choose a different preset. They have like sunny, overcast, night, studio. And this is just a super quick way to look dev your materials and create them. And then you can jump into the PBR window and see how it looks rendered out. So that's something really cool, is this new window. Everything's been simplified with Angie, which is so rad, and it's only going to get better. It's amazing to see the developers really, really working hard to make this amazing. So I would say, guys, go try Angie Early Access. Go give it a shot. Go play with it. So I'm super excited for the future of Angie, and it's going to be definitely a game changer, and it's going to be, for me, a tool that I will probably use on every project now, because it's so, so freaking fast. Really excited about Angie. Anyway, those are my initial impressions and thoughts on Angie, and I hope you enjoyed this video. And don't forget to subscribe, like the video, all that fun stuff, and hopefully we'll see you in the next video, and it won't be like 6 months. Bye.